we saw similarities between the early Freecheirs and a travelling rock band, how they'd travel around from city to city and set up their show and people come along to watch, and they perceive the people they're watching as being so different to them, when in fact they're not that different, they just have a few differences.
It's not the feeling that you have got out of playing so many shows and being traveling around in the world.
Yeah, it's just not like we still really enjoy it. Playing was our favourite thing out of everything that we do, but it can feel pretty freaky at times.
Do people treat you like freaks?
Not really. They just look at you as being different sometimes. But really you're just a normal person, just like them, same sort of sense of humour and stuff like that. It's not like you're really different in any other way.
Spårade av sina hårdrockande pappor bildades Silverchair i den lilla staden Newcastle i Australien 1992. Sångaren Daniel och trummisen Ben började först ihop, sen träffade de Chris som spelar bas. De fick skivkontrakt och innan trion blåste ut 15 ljus i födelsedagsfotan så kunde de fira sin första topplistetta hemma i Australien med EP:n Tomorrow. Sen gick allt ganska fort. Precis som i fallet Roxette slog de igenom i USA tack vare alerta radiodiskjockeys som började spela deras singlar.
We were pretty surprised because we didn't expect any success in Australia and alone anywhere else in the world, so it was a bit of a shock, but it was good. We didn't, when we heard people were playing the song on the radio and stuff, we didn't expect it to, we didn't think all of a sudden we'd be big in America. We just said, oh, they're going to play it for a while and then stop. But, you know, it turned out to do us well.
4 miljoner sålda exemplar av debuten Frogstomp, fyllda konserthallar som här i London. Ja, visst har livet förändrats för de tre unga som ännu inte nått svensk systembolagsålder. Men killarna i Silverchair, de försöker leva som vanligt ändå. De pendlar mellan konserthus och skolbänk och deras föräldrar, de turas om att hålla ett vakande öga över dem under turnéerna.
How about your friends at home, Daniel? Do they treat you the same way?
Yeah, we've had the same friends for long time now, so we're just the same to them and they're the same to us. We're just the same people. We still do the same things when we're at home. Just go to mate's houses and just hang out and play pool and fall asleep on his lounge. There's no real change.
But aren't there other people who treat you in a different way because they know who you are these days?
You just gotta really block them people out and just ignore them because you know they're not really a friend. They're just there really because you're different, I suppose. They think you're different. I don't know, you just ignore them really.
Det är ofrånkomligt. Man tänker på Kurt Cobain när man ser sångaren Daniel Johns på scen. Men när det gäller Silverchairs ljudbild så låter de inte som Nirvana, Pearl Jam eller Alice in Chains. Inte längre i alla fall. För det nya albumet Freak Show, det är renodlad hård rock.
It's more, I don't think it's more angry, it's just more expressed. The first album was angry but it wasn't expressed quite as well. This album's fairly aggressive, especially in the harder songs.